you don't pray, it will not achieve them. It's not a matter of you need that. The warfare in Christianity is one of them. I tell you, because the thing that will ensure that you survive, the answer of darkness is your prayer altar. Why do you think the devil attack your prayer? Why? Because that's the first line defense of a believer. Jesus Christ taught two things. I end with this. When you came, you believed in the kingdom. How did the kingdom of God is this? The kingdom of God is that, the kingdom of God is that. When he was about to go, he had to take them prayer. Because what they saw him preaching was what he prayed at night. He had to take them prayer because he knew if he doesn't take them prayer, they will deny the kingdom of God. Speaking the tongues with their mouths. All the confusion of Peter, while he came in the very situation, even if he had a way, he denied. That is the same way you deny Jesus if the Holy Ghost is not helping. But Peter was supposed to pass life. It's because Jesus can't pray for him that he's praying before him. Judas, Jesus did not pray for him. So he felt the only way to redeem himself was to go and kill himself. If nobody prayed for you, time is going to come. The warfare will surround you. The reason why you survive today is because people are praying for you. You may not even know that they are praying for you. They are praying for you. Some of you, your mother, some of you, your father, some of you, your friends. How many of your friends have you prayed for? They don't even know you are praying for them. You are heavily praying for them. So, now you encounter God, they don't know that you are the one. Anytime you say to people and get born again, somebody prayed. You may not know somebody to you. Prayer is one of the things that always enhance the move of God in nature. Christianity was a move of prayer and power. I'm telling you, every other manifestation was a byproduct of these two things. The same way, your life can only truly advance by the strength and the energy and the incense of prayer. There is nothing that is taken to heaven except the prayer of men. Nothing but to heaven except our prayer. And prayer is a diverse manner. Intercession, supplication, thanksgiving, all kinds of prayer. We are the only one that thinks prayer is talks alone. When we go with you for like 20 hours, for like 30 hours, it's called that prayer goes beyond just what you think. Your altars will finish, your prayer will finish. At that time, you will not begin to pray very well. Because the Bible says you can only truly pray when the Holy Ghost helps you. You do not know how to pray as God. The Spirit of God help you to become the lake and water. And the Bible speaking says, men ought to always pray. And you don't know how to pray as you ought to pray. So when Jesus Christ came, he began telling them to understand that when you pray, same thing. Because whether you like it or not, situations and challenges of life will force you to pray. One day you pray. He said, when you pray, when he said, teach us to pray, he said, no, you don't have to come to pray. You learn prayer by praying. So, when you want to pray, this is what you should say. Why? Because I was not taught prayer forever. I came and begin to pray because it's your normal lifestyle. Men ought to pray. Live by prayer. You die by praying. You survive by praying. Prayer must be your love language. I know by the chapman, I've told you many things. He's a psychologist. I am not a motivational speaker. I'm not a psychologist. I'm the man of the spirit. Love language is prayer. What you find is prayer. Your goal of operation is prayer. You are a sinner. Only prayer will unlock you. The possibilities of God that lies in your life can only be unlocked by prayer. When you don't pray, you will see the seven seas. You will die a chicken. You will die a carnival. When you pray, even if you die, you will make God a debtor. Because you are amazing and you pray. It covers the work of your prayer. The Bible speaks about men of faith in the book of Hebrews 11. Some of them were men that through faith endure many things and pray many things. And they make God a debtor. The Bible says, they would have not made it come perfect. Me and you are doing the things we do today because of people praying. And they died, not receiving the reward. So me and you must rise. The same way I'm praying today. For a whole generation to rise, if it means for me to die, I will die. But then the thousand of them rise. I'm not only praying for good things. I pray to get the reward from God. I pray to employ God. I pray to make God a temple. No water. My mother died. But through me, many mothers will live, will not die. My father died, no problem. But through me, many fathers will die. Many fathers will live. But the only way that can be possible is when you are a woman and a man of prayer. If you are not a man and a woman of prayer, I assure you, if devil do not keep you, you will make your life miserable. I have seen miserable people. Miserable people that don't pray. Some miserable. They don't know the realm of advantage. Prayer is a transporter of the spirit. It takes you to a realm where the possibility of God lies. And let me tell you, if you don't learn how to pray long hour prayer, you don't have strength in God. You don't have energy in God. Take all to the life of Jesus. He prayed every day. Every fact, Jesus paid more than he thought. He said, when you pray, whether you like it or not, circumstances of life will force you to pray.